So dear students, today we will learn about character formatting, another topic in OpenOffice ORG Writer. So before discussing the character formatting, we should know about the meaning of the term formatting. Do you know what is the meaning of formatting? So whenever we are using the word processor, we need to format our document. So what is the meaning of formatting? Formatting means to change the appearance of our text, so that it looks more attractive, it looks more presentable. So whenever you take the printout after typing something, when you get it on the paper, it should look very attractive, it should look presentable, it should look eye-catching, and there shouldn't be any mistake in the printout. So the formatting is divided into three categories. The first category that we are going to learn today is character formatting. The second category is the paragraph formatting, and the third category is the page formatting. So now we will learn about that, how we can do the character formatting. So character formatting deals with the text, to change the appearance of the text, to make it more attractive by changing the font size, alignment, font color, making it bold, italic, underline, like that. So how can we format the text? We can format the text by going to the format menu, and when you click on the format menu, then select the character option. So as we select the character option, a character dialog box will appear. As you can see, there are two dialog boxes given at the bottom. The first is the menu where you click, and then you click on the character option from the format menu. So as you click on the character option, the character dialog box will open. And this character dialog box has many tabs, the font tab, the font effect tab, and the position tab, and the background tab. So each tab contains different formatting features, or we can say the character formatting feature. The first tab is the font tab. From the font tab, what we can do is we can change the font style of the text. We can apply any font style such as Comic Sans, or we can make it government, we can give Arial, or we can apply Times New Roman, or whatever font you may want to apply. Then we can give typeface, yeah, means you can make it bold, italic, underline, whatever you want to do. Then we can also change the size of the font. We can increase the size of the font, we can decrease the size of the font using the font tab. So we will learn about the font tab. The font tab, as I have told you, contains the font. Font means that whatever font you want to apply, Times New Roman, Arial, you can click on the type of font that you want to apply. And typeface is the bold, italic, underline. Click on bold, click on italic, click on underline. Whatever you want, whatever formatting you want to apply. In case of size, you can select a particular size, 11, 12, 13, 14, 20, 22, whatever size you want to apply to the text. So we can give different types of fonts, different type of font sizes to the font by using that character formatting. So this is about the first tab that we have, that is the font tab. In the font tab, there is one more option, that is the language, and as we obviously are learning through the English, so we will choose the English language. Otherwise, if there is any other language which is loaded on the software, then we may also use the other language. But we are using the English of US or UK. So this can also be done through the formatting toolbar. So I think all of you know about the formatting toolbar. There are two toolbars which are always available while we are working on Word or Writer or Excel or PowerPoint, and these two toolbars are standard toolbar and the formatting toolbar. So the standard toolbar contains the standard features such as copy, paste and all, but in the case of formatting toolbar, it contains the options which are related to formatting, the same features that we can access from the font tab of the character dialog box. So here you can see the formatting toolbar is there. So here we have font styles, we have font sizes, we have bold, italic, underline. We also have the alignments that we can apply to the text. Now let's come to the next tab of the character dialog box, and that is fonts effects tab. After applying fonts and all, we can apply different types of special effects to the font. So what are the different effects that we can apply to the font? As we click on the font tab, we have different type of font effects which are available, and these font effects can be given by choosing a particular type of font effect from the dialog drop down list of the font effects. So the different type of font effects which, or we can say the font color we can also change. So different type of font effects which are available are capital, lowercase, title case, small case, embossed, engraved, outline, overline, strike through, double strike through. So all these effects are available that we can apply to the font or the text that we are typing in the word processor. So every effect has a different type of style, a different type of result that I will demonstrate to you after the topic. So then the third tab is the position tab. So the position tab is used to change the position of the text. So now you will say, what does it mean, the position of the tab? Position of the text means that generally the font is written or the text is written at a normal position, which is in line, baseline there is of the text, and all the text is written on that particular baseline. But what we can do, we can change the orientation of the text by raising it from the normal position, which is called a superscript, or we can lower it from the normal baseline, that is called as the subscript. For example, you want to write x square. Now x is normal, but square that you write for the x should be raised from the baseline. So that can be done with the help of the superscript. Or you want to write a h2o. Now in case of h2o, h and o are at the same baseline, but 2 is lower down from the baseline. So that can be done with the help of the subscript. So you can also change the orientation of the text in degrees. As you can see, if we rotate the text to 90 degrees, then how it looks. If we rotate the text to the 270 degrees, then how it looks, and all. Then we can also change the background of the text. Background means we can change the background color of the text. By default, the background color of the text is white and the font color of the text is black. So both can be changed. So by using the background, we can change the background color of the selected text. So how we can do that? We can click on the character dialog box that is already open. We can click on the background tab and we select the type of the color as we want to apply as the background, and we finally click on the OK button. So we should take care that whenever we are applying the background, that the foreground and background are in contrasting colors. If the foreground is light, then the background should be dark, and if the foreground is dark, then background should be light in color. Now please note down these few questions that you have to do. What is character formatting? What are the different types of font effects that we can provide to the text? Write the steps to apply background color to the text. And now it's the time for demonstrating you how all these things happen. So let us see. Open a word processor. So we are using an OWriter. The same you can do in the MS Word also. There are slight difference only, but all things are same. So we click on the format, as you can see, and after clicking on format, we click on the character dialog box. So the first thing that we should do, that I have not done, now I will do, that we have to select the text. So now here is the text that I am selecting. So here the text is selected, and now we click on. So first thing that we should do is to select the area, select the text to which we want to apply character formatting, and then we click on the format option and click on the character, and the character dialog box will appear. Open and click on the font tab, and now you can see different type of font effects are given here. So we can click on any font that we, so let us choose Roman here. And you can see here is the option bold italic we can choose, and we are choosing the font size as 40. So let us see what is the output. So you may see the text has become large, the font size has changed, and so this we can also do from here. That is the character formatting. Formatting dialog box is here. We can change the font color from directly from here also, as we want to apply the red color. So you can see the color has become red. So this we can do from the font tab. This we can use, do from the font tab. Now let us see what is else we can do. We click on the format, click on character, and after clicking on character, we click on the font effect tab. Now from the font effect tab, you can see different type of, we can, here we can change the color, and after changing the color, we can see that what effects we can apply.